Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. Yesterday, the railway minister, while answering one of the questions regarding the movement of coal, said that it was not always the railway's fault. I do agree that it is not always the railway's fault. The whole difficulty is that there is no coordination between his ministry and the other ministries. He also suggested that they would like to divert some of the coal to road and waterways. I do welcome that suggestion. From today's papers, I find that the World Bank, the Planning Commission, and the Railway Ministry had a meeting with shipping companies who are willing to supply 24 more ships to transport 1 million odd tons of coal to the south. In this connection, I would suggest that transport by barter costs rupees 37 more per ton. Secondly, the coal supplied through ships is not graded properly, in the sense that it gets mixed up. When they supply it to industries, the latter do not get the proper quality, and what they get is not up to the mark. These things should be taken care of while diverting more and more coal towards the south through waterways. Sir, I have to say another thing. In the Niyogi committee, it was suggested that the railways should consider the question of their contribution to the general revenues. I do not say that the contribution from the railways to the general revenues is not good. It is quite welcome, but what I would suggest is that the railways can ill afford this much now that they have increased their dividend. They are not in a position to divert to that extent to the railway revenues. If they have increased their dividend, it does not mean that the railways are prosperous, but what I feel is that the railways would do well to think twice about paying more because they have got any amount of work to be done in their own department. The dividend was increased on the understanding that there would be no change in the rates of freights, but the railways are not in a position to increase their freight rates because they have to face severe competition from other means of transport. Moreover, an increase in the contribution to the general revenues may affect national development. Therefore, I suggest that they should reconsider the decision about their contribution to the general revenues. Sir, the railways are a crucial combination of a commercial concern and a public utility organ. On the one side, they have to spend more and more on the comforts of the nation and on the other contribute more and more to the national development. Full stop.